well, this guy's in my combine.
I was getting bored sitting around at home, and I just figured I'd come jump in a combine. Turns out it was Nick's.
Well, today's a different day. Things are going pretty good. We're rolling along. This combine's been awesome for us. Love it. But something's different today. I'm trying to figure out what it is. It's like a presence is in the area. A kind of offshoot from red, more like a green presence, but I don't know. And then there was some corn on the ground earlier, and it reminded me of somebody. I was like, this guy, he's kind of like this tall. He's got these like witty one-liners, kind of like, what the heck is that thing right there? And this guy.
Yeah, it's me, Nick. It's me.
Zach.
Yeah, it's the hat. That's the green.
Oh, the hat. Well, what's the deer have to do with it?
Well, it's a machinery company.
Huh.
Yeah, they make machines for farming.
And people know about this?
Some.
Do people use these machines?
Oh, yeah, most. Most people have successful farms run these machines.
So yeah, Zach is here. He's passed through. They were on a trip across the High Line, and we just happened to be on the line that they took.
In our way, basically.
Actually, we're here with this thing. So let's climb inside. I'm gonna teach Zach the ropes, this 8250. Get him a chance to drive a red machine, because you've never driven a red machine.
I've never run a red machine, no. I have run a quad track.
Okay.
I have never run whatever this thing is.
This thing, whatever the heck that thing is. Okay, yeah. Well, this thing's fully automated, so there's a couple steps we gotta take. So let's go ahead and get that started, get Zach on the road, and put him to work here, because we got acres that still need to cut, and well, your harvest isn't for like another 6 weeks, so.
I'm very bored this time of year. I had to come looking for some work.
Well, okay, let's get started. So this is the new cab, the 8250, new nice leather seats. Pretty good visibility. I'm sure it's better than anything you've ever sat in before, but.
Well, we don't have to get into that.
Well, first things first, with this combine, they've changed the way you start it up. So first thing you do is put your hand on the Pro 700, and it'll do a quick scan.
On the screen here?
Yep, yep, go ahead and hold it on there.
Okay. It doesn't hurt?
No, it's just gonna analyze you real quick, just to make sure if you're a capable operator on the machine.
Okay.
Remember I said it's fully automated.
Okay, all right.
Operator green levels exceeding automation parameters.
Oh, that's interesting.
Access denied.
Try it again.
Operator green levels exceeding automation parameters. Access denied.
Try one more time.
Yeah, let's do one more time.
Operator green levels exceeding automation parameters.
That's kind of awkward. I'm sorry, guys.
Access denied.
I actually didn't know this was going to happen, but okay. Well, you know, here. Just try this real quick. Put that hat on. This might be what's going on. A little too much green. No, it's okay. It won't hurt you.
Not going to show anyone?
No, I won't. I won't air this. Okay. All right, try it again.
Wow. Oh. You are handsome. Competent operator detected. Access granted.
There we go.
That's better?
That fixed it.
Okay.
Combine knows.
Can I have my hat back now?
Yeah, you can. That is a nice hat. All right, with that awkward moment out of the way.
It happens.
Does your head feel a little different?
Yeah, it does. I have quite a headache, actually.
Is it a headache? Is it kind of hurting?
It's just right. Yeah, it's like a migraine.
That's weird, huh? Interesting. Okay, well, we'll figure that out. But let's get to the field, guys, right now.
Nope.
How close is your closest deer dealer?
9 miles.
See, that's pretty nice.
Yeah, anytime we call them and need something, they've already got somebody headed our way to go somewhere else, so they throw the belt or whatever in with them, and they
honestly,
drop it at the driveway, and we're good.
Our local case dealer is about 15 miles, which isn't bad. That's not bad, but like 9 miles, I mean, we've ran that far just to go to the other side of the farm to harvest. Like, between our winter wheat crops are 9 miles apart. Like, so if we just rode our equipment that far, I mean, you've had a deer that close, it'd be so nice to be able to just, yeah.
Isn't this one going to go in the grain cart?
You want to? You know you want to.
I mean, I think we probably should.
Yeah, I would if I were you
guys. I don't know, though. I like combining them.
You know, combining is a lot of fun. It's
usually when guys offer, like, you know, if you're getting tired in that combine, I can come take over. Like,
yeah, I'm good.
I think I got it for another 3 weeks or so.
They're pretty slick. Even this one too, with the automated feed rate, it's just one less thing you're worrying about. Zach is dumping on the go.
Boy, I don't know what I'm doing. Who does?
That's a valid point. I'm pretty sure none of us do.
What are we doing out here, anyways? See what he's doing?
I know what we should be doing.
Eating?
We're filming right now.
All right, retake.
Retake.
He's a good operator.
Is that your Suburban coming from this way?
Yes, it is, I think. There's leg arms.
The leg arms.
The leg arms with little leg arms is in there. And Mrs. Leg Arms and little Mrs. Leg Arms. Oh, he's done.
He's done. We're going to go get the bowling ball.
You want to get that bowling ball, Onyx? Oh, yeah. There it is. You see it?
First.
Okay. Go ahead, buddy.
All right, go on now, boys. Get it.
So bad.
Onyx.
Nice.
Strike.
Good job, Onyx. So not only are Minnesotians good at driving combines, they're really good at retrieving bowling balls in the field.
Which is,
where do you guys learn this stuff at?
That's the first thing you always put on a job resume.
Is
good at bowling ball field retrieval.
Retrieving.
Yeah.
Bowling ball retrievers.
Because they're going to ask you.
So you guys have been asking forever for us to get together and do a collab together. It's like every other comment. You and Emma Millennial should get together. You and Emma Millennial should get together.
Are you guys happy now?
We hate each other. I can't stand this guy. I mean,
the feeling is mutual.
Yeah, like we literally we had like a 10-minute stare down when he pulled in the yard. I just stared at him. I was like, him. Like leg arms, get the gun. No, actually, it's pretty cool. I'm honestly, there's a big fat rock.
I didn't know what to put.
Grab.
I panicked.
It's okay. That is actually a pretty good size rock.
Just fine.
He almost deliberately scooped up that rock just to put it through his case combine.
That's a cute little rock, though.
Yeah, is that not a Minnesota? That's like a baby Minnesota rock.
You don't worry about those. You don't stop for those.
Oh, okay. Those just go through the John Deere. Nice, man. You feel like you.
I think you. I've run a combine before, but not one this color.
Yeah, this is kind of weird for you, isn't it?
When I brought
you up to it, you were kind of sure, like, what. I mean, is this a lawnmower or is this a? This is a combine.
It's a zero turn lawnmower.
The big zero turn lawnmower.
So you told me earlier that you'd never really, nobody around here says combining.
Not very often.
What do you say?
Cutting.
Cutting.
Yep. Did you go cut?
Well,
are you guys cutting?
Sense.
Have you cut yet?
Threshing.
Have you tried cut? Not very much. Harvesting. We do a lot of that. Like, are you guys harvesting yet?
Combining is the most common around us.
But since I've gotten acquainted to these row crop people, I actually have been
people
using the
like
term
us.
Combining quite a bit. And I've been really careful to say pick corn and combine corn.
Yeah. See, my buddy Randy, he'll say picking corn.
Does he?
Is 80 years old?
Is that an old term, or is that for like sweet corn?
No, that'd be for like sweet corn or 100-year-old guys from back when they used to pick corn.
Got it. So after we got Zach authorized to drive this combine, it was a little bit tricky, but we got the training wheels off. He's good to go. We're gonna jump into the quad track, because why not, right? I mean, it's here, and he's here, and Onyx is here. It's time to ride a quad track.
I was actually thinking we could fire leg arms and hire Zach.
No.
Yeah, that's not a bad plan.
What's gonna happen is you're gonna fire me. I'm gonna go work for Zach.
Wait.
That works too. Our harvest is much later than yours, so that works out.
Oh, yeah, that would be great.
Do you want him on your place?
Do you want a bowling ball can?
Of course I want a double barrel bowling ball.
Yeah, this is getting over the top.
Okay, we're switching to the quad track. Yes.
I haven't heard him say yet once, what the heck is that thing?
If you want to know a little secret, I've always known. There it is.
Do you want me to put that on there?
Yeah, you can put it. Yeah, it's just, I've been acting. I'm an actor. I am the actor that plays the Millennial Farmer
the whole time. Fake.
Yeah, no, I knew what Case was.
This whole time.
Yeah, it's just that darn good of an actor.
You just let down like 380,000 people.
You can edit it out then if you want.
I don't know if I'm gonna. I think I'm gonna keep it.
You guys just heard that.
You heard it.
There is no such thing as what the heck is that thing.
Well, I'll still pretend I
Oh, you will. You guys are probably guy. This guy's driving the quad track.
I can drive anything red.
He just jumped in and went. I didn't have to tell him what to do. He's unloading my dad on the go.
If you want to see how difficult it actually was to get me to figure this thing out, you can watch my video.
Yeah.
We kind of got to do the goofy camera back and forth thing here, but.
See,
hey, I got this.
Leg arms is dumping in the cart, which is dumping in the truck. Zach's running the whole thing. And I am not distracting him right now.
No, I'm used to it.
Yeah. Nice work. Good job.
Look at that. I did it.
He's a boss.
I unloaded some wheat.
Have you ever grown wheat on your farm?
Oh. Really? There used to be some wheat around us when I was younger. Now, very little.
I'd say it's a cash crop, but it's absolutely not, so I wouldn't even bother. It's not right if these guys leave without seeing the cannon go off. So we told Zach that the combine could take it if we shot at the A250 because they're built that tough.
So my suggestion, of course, was, well,
are we going to do it?
Let's see it then.
Unfortunately, our demo time ran out, so we can't start it to get in front of the cannon.
Onyx, we got to send that bowling ball home. Are you up for that?
Yes.
All right, spin the cannon around. We're taking out the quad track.
Whoa, guys.
Whoa.
I mean, that'd be cool.
Let me make a phone call first and see if it's okay with Case.
I thought this was a collab.
Oh.
Isn't that's how this works?
It could take us.
All right, spin the cannon around. We're taking out the quad track. we better not. All right, we'll just fire it at the wheat field then.
Yeah.
Onyx, go ahead and just throw it right in there.
See, we've never paused our harvest to fire a bowling ball into a wheat field.
You guys are missing out.
Here we go.
3, 2, 1, and then you pull the cord. And make sure you look up that way.
Time to go home there, ball.
Turn around and face this way, because it's going to go way out that way.
Yeah, you got to watch it.
Okay, bud. You're good to go. Now count down.
3, 2, 1.
There it is. Boom! Oh, you see it? Nice hit, Onyx.
Man.
That was right where you found that ball.
Well, it's been fun, Zach. It's been real short. He didn't have a lot of time here, but we did get some time with some equipment.
We overstayed our welcome by a little bit.
Yeah,
but I helped you out. Look at the hours I put in.
Happened was you were doing fine, and then you threw the deer hat while you're in that thing, and it threw the whole system off.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah, it's okay. So I was wondering, though, what if we were in your neck of the woods sometime? I mean, can we poke our head in for a second?
I think you should, because I could use some help running some trucks.
Well, I just want to climb that grain leg a couple times.
Yeah, that would be good, too.
And I thought that'd be
there's a
fun.
Grease gun up top.
Is there?
You wouldn't mind when you're up there.
I could grease that thing. Well, fun, guys.
You could run a corn combine.
Do I have to do the hat thing?
It's green and far superior. Yeah.
Okay, we'll see how that goes, guys. Maybe I'll put a pull up and you guys can decide if that's something that I should even do. Do I bring leg arms?
Yeah.
Man,
you bring everybody.
Well, it's a done deal, guys. It's going to happen. Unless something happens between then on Instagram or something. You never know what might float around.
Yeah. I mean, the relationship could fall apart.
With all that said, thanks for coming, Zach.
Thank you, Nick, for having us.
It's been a pleasure.
The whole Welker family.
Definitely. It's been a blast, and it's been fun meeting these guys in person, a lot in common, and definitely, guys, if you haven't, go to MM Millennial. Check out his channel. Great channel. A lot of good content. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all the above. He's on there. Even got podcasts.
Yep.
The guy's all over the map, and he's fun. So go follow him. Go subscribe and like his videos. No fun. They just wouldn't leave. I was like, guys.
I'm going to miss those guys. They're awesome. Like, literally, those guys are like the best.
Minnesotians. I just don't get it.
Bye.
I just don't get it. Okay, we got 3 trucks going to the field. Blue Pete, Red Pete are already pretty much there. That one's actually going down the road. International's right here taking off. Got leg arms and that. 2 combines are cutting. Rain's supposed to come in about 2 hours, so we'll see what we get. That girl right there, unfortunately, is houred out. We ran out to the 50 hours we had it, and she's gonna sit for now. But it does look good in the yard. I like seeing that thing every time I go by. You guys have been giving me a lot of heat for not picking up rocks in the field, because every time they get in the combine, you're like, why don't you pick that rock up so you don't get in the combine again? Because we've got millions of rocks out here and I'd spend my whole life doing it. But for you guys, there. Are you satisfied? You know, all banter aside, it was honestly a lot of fun having Zach here for the little bit he was here. It wasn't long, but we did get to play in the field a little bit, and it's all good. We get along just fine, and you know, I'm looking forward to be able to spend some time with them in the future. But yeah, I wish it could have been longer. It'd been fun. Maybe one of these days we can do like a, you know, like the wife swap show on TV. Let's do like a farmer swap show where Zach, like, you know, spends a harvest season at Welker Farms, and I spend the harvest season in MM Millennial Farms. How about that? I think that's a good idea, right? We'll be right back. was gone, the guys finished filling all of our grain bins. We are 100% out of grain storage on this farm, as far as grain bins go. We got one pile of grain on the ground. We have a grain bag to do another pile. We've got plans to hopefully take care of the rest of the grain. What we're gonna do right now is we're gonna use the auger to put the tarp on top of the one pile that we've already made. Because there is some rain coming, we have the tarp, we're gonna go put it on it. So the idea is to suspend the tarp package on top of the end of the auger, back the auger over the pile, let it down, and then unfold the tarp over it. That's what we're thinking. Let's see if we can do it. Guys, making progress. Burn a lot of diesel, but we're getting the crop in. That's what matters. So really appreciate you guys watching the videos, and definitely subscribe to the channel if you have not. Like the video, gives it a thumbs up. That's nice to do. And if you guys want all the updates on when I put videos out, make sure you click on the little bell in the corner. It's there somewhere. And check that bell. That'll give you alerts when new videos are up. That way you can be the first to see it. Unless you want to see it before everybody else, then become a YouTube member or a patron. Links are in the description below, or the YouTube membership's right there, you can join. I try to get videos out a day early for everybody who's one of those. So, again, guys, take care, God bless. We'll see you in the new one.